Now we'll find the central mass of a solid hemisphere. So if this is a solid hemisphere of mass m, by symmetry again, we can see that its central mass will be located on y-axis or the vertical line passing through the center of this hemisphere, which is also normal to the base, and say the diametrical line passing through the base we consider as x-axis for calculation. Again, to find central mass for a continuous object, we need to consider an element. So, in this situation, here, we consider an elemental disk of mass dm. In this situation, at a height y from the center, we consider a disk which will be of width dy, and we consider its mass to be dm. For calculation of dm, we need to multiply the mass per unit volume to the mass, the volume occupied by the disk. In this situation, the radius of disk can be simply given as r is the radius of this hemisphere. The radius of this elemental disk we can write as root of r square minus y square. Now, the elemental mass can be given by m upon the total volume, that is 2 by 3 pi r cube. This is the mass per unit volume because the mass m is distributed uniformly in the half sphere volume, that is 2 by 3 pi r cube, which is multiplied by the volume occupied by the disk. Here the surface area of disk is pi small r square and the width is dy, so it can be written as pi small r square dy. So this can be written as 3m by 2 pi r cube into pi r square, can be written as r square minus y square into dy. Here pi gets cancelled out and this will be the elemental mass dm. And to find the y coordinate of center of mass, use the common expression 1 by m integration of dmy, where y is the y coordinate of elemental mass dm. In this situation, y is the only coordinate which is expressing the height of this dm from center. So directly we use y. So here it is 1 by m integration of, if we substitute the value of dm, you can see it is 3m upon 2r cube into r square minus y square dy multiplied by y. Now, as we are integrating in terms of y, we substitute the limits of y from 0 to r. Because for this solid hemisphere, we need to integrate all such disks one over another from bottom to the top of this hemisphere. So, limits will be from 0 to r. Here, m gets cancelled out. Finally, we'll be having this 3 by 2 r cube constant out of the sign of integration. Within integration, it is r square y minus y cube into dy from 0 to r. If we just integrate it, which is quite easy to integrate, we can write 3 by 2 r cube. And it becomes r square y square by 2 minus y 4 by 4. Limits we substitute from 0 to r. So if we substitute the limits, this will be 3 by 2 r cube. Inside it will be r 4 by 2 minus r 4 by 4. So it will be, you can write r 4 by 2 minus r 4 by 4. This is r 4 by 4. So it will become 3r by 8. Here you can see that this r cube will cancel out with the fourth power of this r. So final result will be 3r by 8, which is again a useful result to be used in various problems, which says that for a solid hemisphere, its central mass is located at a height 3r by 8 from the center along the line passing through center normal to its base.